service after all. Yes, thank you very much indeed to those two gentlemen for excellent recommendations. Each week, of course, I like to play a hip-hop track because I like to keep it real, keep it urban on the show. And here's an absolute dynamite tune from The Roots featuring Erykah Badu.
BBC Six Music.
The Roots featuring Erykah Badu and You Got Me. Now, if you are a regular listener to the Steve Show Six Music, that's what you're listening to at the moment, Steve Merchant Six Music Steve Show. If you're a regular listener, then I just wanted to make it clear for everyone. If you're a regular listener, you will know that I have been catching up with an old close friend, Dave, who I didn't speak to for about 5 years, and then I spoke to him before the beginning of the first show. And it turns out he's walking from Land's End to John O'Groats for no reason. And we like to get him on because he's got excellent music taste and recommend a tune for us, but also just find out how his arduous task is going. Dave, are you there?
I am, Steve. How's it going with you?
I'm all right, mate, but how about you? How are the legs?
Well, you keep saying it's for no reason, and, you know, I try and clarify that there is a reason, but then you keep pressing
me.
Well,
you say you clarify, but you haven't yet given us a reason.
No, but that's, you know, part of the whole mystique of the event.
But that's what I'm saying, is you haven't given us a reason.
Anyway, how are the legs? Good question.
How are the legs? Are you
exhausted?
Oh,
yeah, much better,
yeah. Are you all right?
Yeah, athletic supports are the future.
Have you found it harder than you expected?
The walking? Yes. Mainly I'm struggling with the fact that everyone seems to be staring at me. And the further you get from, you know, the kind of places where people do walking, and you get towards where I am now in the West Midlands.
Well, they don't walk, they fly, of course, up there famously.
Birmingham. You know, it's a little bit odd to see someone, so...
Sure. Yeah. But you're sort of enjoying it, or is it just proving kind of a fun?
Oh, it's a laugh a minute, literally, yeah.
And what do you do of an evening? Where do you sleep? Did you just fall exhausted into a ditch? Or what are you doing?
I roll up to whichever pub or B&B or guest house would have me. And I use my wits and looks and charm. And then when that doesn't work, I just get out the cash. And they take me in for the night. There's no one else around these days. Everything is empty. It's great. I've got a whole place to myself.
Make a suggestion, right, just to spice things up for the next bit before we speak to you again. Why don't you just walk with your penis? Just pop it out through your trousers and just walk. You know, like some people do these walks nude. They do, like, nudist walks, don't they? Just do that and just see, you know, because it gives us something interesting to talk about next time. Because my worry is that I'm going to say, where are you, and you're going to tell me, blah, blah, blah. What about that? Because that would be cool. Just, you know, pop it through the trousers.
He could say, I'm Ian Botham, and here's my elephant.
Exactly. Perfect. So it's just a little idea. I mean, I'll leave it with you, Dave. It's up to you, mate.
I'm up for it, but I don't think anyone would notice.
Sure. Now, where have you reached so far?
I'm in a place called Penkridge, which is somewhere between Cannock and Stafford in West Midlands.
Okay, and how long do you think it's going to take before you reach John O'Groats?
John O'Groats? I don't know, another four or five weeks,
that's obscene. How are you bankrolling this? You know what, I'm not even going to find out. I want to find out next time we speak to you about how you've bankrolled this preposterous expedition.
I haven't really thought about that yet.
Which tune are you going to recommend for us this week?
Okay, my choice this week is a bit of obscure lolloping folk, which I found on some compilation or other. It's by someone called Paul Parrish, English Sparrow, and it's ripe for hip-hop sampling if anyone into that kind of thing.
Thank you very much. Well, all the best as usual. We'll speak to you very soon.
No problem.
All right. Hope the legs feel better.
I'll try the penis thing.
Please do.
No problem. Bye.
Paul Parrish, English Sparrow, the recommendation of Dave the Walker. We wish him all the best as usual. Thank you for all your recommendations as to which Maximo Park track I should play. Keep them coming in, 64046. I trust we've had floods of emails so far. Is there a clear winner so far? Don't tell me what it is, but is there a clear winner so far, Guy?
It seems like one is certainly stretching ahead at the moment, which is a reason for listeners to get in touch and let us know what they think.
And also to stay tuned after the news.
Digital radio.
Digital TV.
BBC Six Music.
Mercury Rev and Hole's cracking tune. It's the Steve Show, Stephen Merchant on Six Music. Now, each week, if you're a regular listener, you will know that I have been trying to help out the Six Music nerds, and we've discovered that many of them are deeply lonely. And as one of the great, the nation's greatest Lotharios, obviously they turn to me to help them win the heart of a lovely lady. Now, I don't know where you are, I don't know where you're listening. Maybe you have noticed that a beautiful blonde, and you're nervous, you don't know what to say, don't know how to approach her. Obviously, what you need to do is give her a beautiful compilation of music as selected by me. Songs which will win her over, poetry, and This is the way to do it. How to get the CD tour is what you're thinking. Okay, once all the tunes have been played over the next few weeks, burn off the CD. That is illegal. Do not do that. I've just realised. And just get a friend to go up to her. And while she's just pulled up in her car, and just, you know, get a friend to go up and say, oh, excuse me, I'm lost, blah, 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 whatever. And then while her back's turned, just slip the CD into the car stereo. All right. So when she then drives off, right, she'll just think, where's this beautiful music come from? And if, as I suspect is the case, you don't have any friends, then you obviously can't do that. So what you should do is wait till night falls and then just jimmy open the car door, right? And make sure you're wearing some gloves, because you don't want to leave fingerprints. So get a pair of marigolds or something. They're very good. Plastic gloves are excellent. And also, maybe wear something in polythene and a hat, maybe a balaclava, because you don't want to leave any fibres. So just break into the car, jimmy it open, right, and just slip the CD into there. And then obviously she'll think, oh my God, I've been broken into, and she'll have to call the police and everything. And then while she's taking the car down to be repaired, hang on a minute, what are these beautiful tunes in the stereo? Whoever this person, and you know, leave your phone number. Alright, so that's just a little advice for you if you're trying to win the heart of a beautiful lady. This week, the tune that I'm going to have, we've had Nick Drake, we've had Bright Eyes. Is that the three we've had so far? Is that two? We've only had those two, right? Yeah, it's shaping up to be a great compilation. I thought we should have a female voice in there, and this is from an album that came out last year. I think it was called His Hands, from Candy Staton, who's probably best known as the vocalist on You Got the Love by The Source, featuring Candy Staton. And this is a beautiful tune called I'll Sing a Love Song to You. Candy Staton, I'll Sing a Love Song to You. The third track, we think, on the Lovers compilation. I think we called it, what were we calling it? Songs to Seduce Women By.
Yeah, something like that.
And hopefully, this is how I see things playing out. You're in the courtroom, you're just being sentenced, having broken into someone's car, and they've also pinned you to a number of other crimes. You weirdo. And then just as you're going down, suddenly this beautiful woman will come bursting in. She'll finally have realised it's you all along. And despite the fact she's given evidence and identified you from a lineup for being the guy that's, you know, stalked her all these years, suddenly she will realise that you are a man of poetry and heart after all, and she will say, no, he's innocent, I'll wait for you. She'll scream as you go down for 6 to 8 years.
you paint a picture with words, Steve. What a romance.
It's a wonderful, wonderful, romantic, beautiful image. Okay, now obviously I am aware that there are many religious listeners. What's Sunday? I like to play a tune for religious people. I myself am not religious, but there is some great music played by religious people. And so I am going to choose a tune by a gentleman called Dion. Now, you may not be familiar with Dion. He was a doo-wop singer in the 50s, and he did some rock and roll hits like The Wanderer and Teenager in Love and Take Good Care of My Baby. And then when he was still in his teens, he got a taste for the smack and slightly derailed his career, but he did eventually clean up, and in the mid-70s he recorded an album with legendary producer Phil Spector. And it was very, very beautiful. Now, I know what Jude's thinking. She's thinking, yeah, it's all very well you're going on about Dion. We've not heard a difficult music question for this week. I'm thinking, fine, but I was being so eloquent about Dion. That's madness. All right, let's hear the quiz question. Then I'll talk more about Dion.
And Richard here with another brain-teasing music question for you. Which artist took the longest time to get to number one? By this I mean, if you had your first hit entry in 1958 and you didn't get a number one till 1970, which artist took the longest time to get to number one?
64046 is the text, if you know the answer to that. It's just a bit of fun. There's no prize. It's not really worth bothering. But it's just a little something. Just a little something for the end of the show. Anyway, so I'm talking about Dion. He was a doo-wop singer. He had the hits. The Wanderer. I called him The Wanderer. They called him The Wanderer. Teenager in Love. Why must I be a teenager in love? All that stuff. And then he put out an album in the 70s after he'd kicked the smack, which was produced by Phil Spector. And the album wasn't a huge success at the time, but as it's often the way, later it was reclaimed and discovered by people like Bobby Gillespie and Pete Townshend and Jason Pierce of Spiritualized. And they all sing its praises now. And the album is called Born to Be With You, and from it, this is a track called Make the Woman Love Me. Jesus Christ, that's good. Make the Woman Love Me from Dion. Dion, you'll be pleased to know, is still going strong, and he put out a blues and country album last year. And the producer of that track, Phil Spector, is of course currently awaiting trial for murder. His trial begins March 19th, so any of our American listeners might want to try and catch that on TV. Obviously, the Steve Show will keep you up to date on any juicy gossip from that particular trial. Now, you might be interested to this. We had Richard's quiz question, and I just thought of a little quiz question of my own, which I think I might just tease you guys with. Dion, okay, is one of only two rock pop stars who features on the cover of Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. All right, there's lots of faces there. Dion is one of them. Who's the other rock pop singer that features on the cover of Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. All right. Harry, Dan.
It's a tricky one.
It is tricky.
Lonnie Donegan.
No.
Okay.
Elvis.
No. Do you know what? I'm going to tease you with that, and I'm going to tell you towards the end of the show.
Oh.
In the meantime, let's hear the answer to Richard's fiendishly difficult quiz question.
I asked, which artist took the longest time to get to number one? The answer to that is Tony Christie, who first entered the charts in 1971, but didn't get his first number one until 2005 with Is This the Way to Amarillo?
Is this the
Do you know no, that?
Oh, don't worry. yes, no, it was indeed Tony Christie. That's excellent. Okay, now then, we asked earlier, right at the top of the show, for recommendations for which Maximo Park track you would suggest if you wanted to introduce that band to me. I trust the suggestions have come flooding in.
Flying in. I'm struggling to get to the mic. You know, I'm reeling really? Through these text messages. There's plenty. Would you like to hear?
Yeah, why not?
Harvey in Enfield says you've got to play Going Missing.
Okay, I don't
by
know.
Maximo Park. Alan has texted in from some mystery location, which is quite nice, and he says it's a shame that they've passed you by. He says Graffiti off their album A Certain Trigger, and David from Norwich, he's disappointed at your lack of Maximo Park knowledge, and says that you must play Apply Some Pressure because he said so.
Harry, is that so? What have we got a final choice?
Yeah, I mean, there have been a lot more suggestions. Dan in Billericay wanted Postcard of a Painting. Sarah Kriegel wanted Kiss You Better or All Over the Shop. Has been the Maximo Park track, Apply Some Pressure.
Apply Some Pressure. I'm completely unfamiliar with it. I hope it's good. Who's been suggesting that?
For example, Steve in London.
Steve in London?
Mm. Henry from Bristol.
Right, go on, Henry.
Yeah. David from Norwich.
Yeah. Nige, Lincolnshire. Yeah. Steve, we could go on. Do you want us to?
Do you know what? No. I don't. I'll tell you what I want to do. I want to hear Maximo Park. That's a pressure from Maximo Park. Yes, I have heard that song before, and so it was a good choice because, yes, I remember it was quite nice. I didn't know it was by Maximo Park. Thanks very much, listeners. I asked you earlier, Dion, of course, is one of the only two rock pop faces that features on the cover of Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. You made some suggestions. They were wrong. The correct answer is Bob Dylan. Is the only other rock pop star face who features on there. Listen, we've pretty much got to wrap it up, guys. Thank you, as always, to Dan and Harry for coming in. Dave the Walking Man, obviously internet guru Vic Sharma, everyone who suggested music, obviously. Thank you very much. And also, if you want to tune in next week, you will find that Stuart Lee, the comedian and also the co-author of Jerry Springer the Opera, will be a guest who's suggesting some tunes. I will leave you with a super cool laid-back record from a funky jazzy singer-songwriter guy who was so talented that he put out his first album when he was 15. He was later asked to play guitar for the Rolling Stones and said, no, I'm not interested. He put out a couple of great albums in the 70s but sort of disappeared from view and has never done much since. But never mind, he influenced people like Prince, and I think this is a cracking tune. From Shuggy Otis, this is Out of My Head. Stuart McConey's Freak Zone is next. Until next week, goodbye.
BBC Six. Music. BBC Six Music. Closer to the music that matters.
Hello, welcome along. Steve Merchant on Six Music, The Steve Show. Let me tell you straight off the bat, I'm not going to lie to you people, I never have, I'm not going to start now. We are not here live in the studio. The show is not live, I am not here. As I'm speaking to you now, I am actually in Los Angeles, the City of Angels, and I am among the beautiful people. The show was pre-recorded many, many weeks ago. Do not text, do not email, do not get in touch. We do not want to hear from you. There is no one here. It is a recording. I am probably, as we speak right now, as it's LA, it's probably about 7 a.m. I am probably just waking up. I've just done 100 press-ups and I'm about to have a healthy shake. And then, of course, I'll have something to drink. Thanks very much. That was gag one of today's Steve Show. And with me, as usual, of course, I've got Harry. Say hi, Harry.
Hi, hi.
And Dan Warren.
Hello.
And you'll notice Dan gets a surname there. Harry, we still don't know what yours is. We're going to tease people with that for the next 18 years.
Yeah, I quite like that. I quite like that.
Now, obviously, I'm in the City of Angels, LA. I'm just taking care of business. I don't want to go into it. I don't want to discuss it. But what are you doing on a Sunday afternoon like this?
Well, I'm glad you asked, Steve. I'm actually in Sydney, Australia. I've actually just probably just had a weak beer, and I'm probably now being bullied by some big hairy men in short-sleeve T-shirts.
Very typical, very much like a usual Sunday. Round of applause, Steve Wright style, for what Harry's doing right now. Dan, what are you up to on a Sunday afternoon?
I would imagine I'll be taking full advantage of your property, Steve,
sure.
Where famously I live, and I'll be taking maximum advantage of the fact that you're not there. Perhaps I'll be going into your palatial room and sprawling on your solid gold sheets.
I should point out that Dan is my tenant and I his landlord, and we don't live together in sin, as it were. Oh well, we've done some pretty naughty things.